So parallelizing collection is done. Now let's see how to create an RDD using external datasets. So when it comes to reading files, the Spark context has a function .text file. So for a demo, let me create a text file. So in the same package only, I'll create a file. I'll mention here anything. Hi, how are you? Session 2, let's say. I'll close it. Now to read this, they are telling we can use sc.text file and we can pass the path to the text file in this function. This path will be given in reference to the main project structure. I have to read this. This RDD has all the data that is in this text file. So let's say as per this example only, we are doing a map to take the length of each line. So let's do data dot map. Let me parallelly keep on explaining this small transformation and action as soon as they are coming. So if you have this is although a very basic transformation, but if you have any confusion on the syntax of map, so let's discuss what map does. So we are doing a map on data. Data is an RDD with this text file. So if we do map on any RDD that is created onto this kind of formatted data, what the map function will do? Map function will perform all the operation line by line what is there in that file or RDD. So whatever we will write in map function, I'll show you how to write. The same function that we have written will be applicable first to this line, second to this line, then so on. So if we have to take length of each line, then you can consider, if you are using map, I'll mention here only, you consider each line as some object, any object name you can give, S, X, anything. So this is our object. Let's say in our example, it's given as S. Now, what you have to do on this line? You have to calculate the length of this. So what will be the syntax of map function? Whatever object name you have considered, that you have to give this operator. So S such that you want the length of what? S. So S dot length. That's it. That's a simple way to understand the syntax of map. So there will be complicated syntax going on. So basically you keep in your mind that the first thing that is the object name that you have considered to every line object. And whatever you want to do with this line, that will be after this. So I have to do map considering each line as S. And which should return S dot length. Okay. If you want the values, assign it and let's see what this val has now for each println. See what it is giving? 6771. 6 length of first, then 6, then 7. So hope you understood it. We are considering each line as an object and operating on that object. So here is a very important point. The text file method also takes an optional second argument for controlling the number of partitions of the file. So if this is a huge file and you want to explicitly define what number of partitions this file should get distributed to, you can also provide that. This is a small file, we don't want to do that. But when we will be handling a big file, we'll use the number of partition and see how that gets distributed. And this will be in the part of our question solving sessions, where we'll have the requirement of altering the number of partitions. So text file, just make a note that we can also, while creating an RDD, we can also define the number of partitions that RDD gets distributed to. It, by default, it creates one partition for each block, blocks in a sense, the HDFS blocks.